Alright, so welcome back for another episode of our GTA playthrough. The last two episodes of this had to be post-commed, and I don't know what's going to be, if those is going to stay post-commed or what, but I couldn't find the audio, I couldn't get the audio. If you guys saw on Twitter, you guys know what happened. So, we're going to be just continuing from where we, when the game last, like, crashed. So, yeah.
Douchebag. Hey, that poor sumbitch we grabbed for you still breathing?
See for yourself, right now. Trevor Phillips is on his way to help with the debrief. Warehouse, off Dutch London in Banning.
Great. Sounds just like my kind of party.
Alright, so we're going to the warehouse. So, let's go ahead and blast off over there. Is this pretty much the last mission? After we do? That's pretty much it. It's like the last. Oh. Okay. What do we have to do Trevor for? I don't get it. My dude.
Taking a dump?
Ah, why do you care, huh?
The fuck is wrong with you?
I got abandonment issues. I gotta see a shrink once a week.
Damn, wipe!
Yeah, well, you know, nothing like meeting a bunch of creeps from the government in a quiet building for someone to grow balls.
See his face that last time I popped it.
Boom!
Oh, ladies!
God, asshole. You back there. I know you, but you, I don't know.
Yeah, well, until I see reason otherwise, why don't we just keep it that way? Steve, what a pleasure, bro.
Oh! He reminds me of one of those guys you see advertising pills for middle-aged men that can't get erections.
Hey, Devin Weston is a very good friend of mine, so why don't you watch your tongue? Because let me tell you something, that guy gets more tail than,
than a tail catcher.
Fucking remember that line. You, where did we meet?
Nowhere, pal.
Yeah, we did.
Hey, pup, what are we doing here, huh?
This.
Please, keep the sleep best of the way from me.
No, Ferdinand, he's gone. Ferdinand. He's gone. It's okay, I've got some new friends here now.
This is Michael, and this is Trevor.
No.
Now, our friend here, he claims he doesn't know
anything. I don't know anything. I don't know. I already told nothing. Nothing. I don't know anything. Please.
You know about the Azerbaijanis?
Huh?
Azerbaijanis.
I do audiovisual, hi-fi audiovisual. It's top man, good price. VIP. No?
You're a fucking spy. And the asswipes at the agency know this. So I need to know. Did you tell them? What did they tell you?
I told them what I tell you. What?
Hey, whoa,
what is this? The house in Rockwood Hills. The man who owns it. He works at the consulate.
Oh,
that's all I know.
That's it. You're gonna make him speak.
No.
You two are gonna drive up to Rockford Hills. No. And when we find out which man is the man with the problem, you put him down. Because I'm tired of these fucking nitwits at the agency taking all the glory.
No.
Hey, fuck is all this, huh?
I think it's a good time, buddy. You know? Go for a drive.
Wait.
You get to work, and I'm not here.
It's Caesar's place. I'm not going to take out his teeth this time, because the first time I took out his teeth, so... I'm not gonna take out his teeth this time. I took out like two teeth, bro. Kinda don't wanna do that, bro.
Yeah, the more I see of your boss, the more I like him.
I was you, I wouldn't be so critical of who others associate with.
So is he gonna be a problem?
For sure. But there's nothing we can do about it. If something happened to him right now, I'd be right under a microscope. An electron microscope of bureaucratic shit. And that... That would make it very difficult to keep old secrets.
Oh, well,
rooting for you.
You know who else is having trouble?
Don't hit any more cards.
You know who else is having trouble keeping secrets, asshole? Me. After you brought Trevor in on this.
I only brought him in after you put out your press release. Townley's taking scores again. The Los Santos reboot. If we didn't control the situation... If we didn't control the situation and he'd unearth this connection, then what?
Then Trevor flips out, beheads me, kills my family, or raises them as his own. I don't know which is worse. Anyway, any of that could happen at any time.
Slow down. Let's think this through. What does he know?
He knows I'm alive. He knows I got money. And now he knows I'm working with the FIB.
Does he know how long you've been working with the FIB?
How long? The fuck does that matter?
Look out! Either you were working with us before the cash you walked your crew into an ambush, one of them spent 10 years on the run, and the other landed in a federal penitentiary. Or we stumbled on the cash depot job, Brad went down, you went down, Trevor got away. The FIB cut you a deal on your sickbed, faked your death, and you end up here.
Who's to say which of those is true?
That there's any doubt probably accounts for you being alive.
Back there, Trevor made you right away, the second he saw you.
You remember after the bust, I was in all the papers. I was on the evening news, the man who killed Michael Townley.
Yeah, I was quite a trophy. A good head to hang on your wall.
Back then, sure. Not now.
Oh, no.
I don't know if I said in the previous recordings, but I have to, like, fuck around with GTA 3. Might stream it sometime after God of War, but I have to play that game.
Bullshit. This place, baby, they've been shooting the real cunts of suburbia here the last few weeks. No way that's your guy.
Shit. You are kidding me. I'll call Steve. Wrong house. This guy isn't our guy.
Okay. You sure you don't want to silence him just to make sure?
We're silencing someone. We're silencing the right someone. Get me another address. Hey, you want a coffee?
Can I get you anything?
Turns out that was the wrong Azerbaijani. We need a new address from Mr. K. Choose your instrument and go to work on it.
Where do we start, eh, buddy?
Wait! What are you talking about, the wrong guy? No! Who do you want? Just tell me what you want, huh, man? Huh, please, look at me, please.
I hope you've been flossing.
Are you still...
No!
Not the pliers. My teeth are perfect. No. Come on!
My finger kind of hurts because this controller's trash.
Best way to make a man talk is to stop him being able to talk.
That hurts too much.
Mr. Phillips, ask him about Tahir Shavon.
What did you ask me? I know Tahir. This is home theater. He lives in Chumas. They're right on the Western Highway.
But that wasn't so tough, was it?
Did you get that? Did you hear him? Lives in Chumash, the Western Highway.
I kind of want to electrocute him this time.
You're driving. Remember, terror does not take coffee breaks.
What a dick. So how are Steve and Trevor getting along?
Seems like a productive relationship.
No,
Well, like I said, he's got his uses.
And as you can see, we're trying to take full advantage of him.
Then what?
This thing with the agency gets put to rest and we don't need you anymore.
Right. And what about Trevor?
What about him?
I need some resolution, Davey. You let him walk. You said you'd clean the whole thing up back in North Yankton.
And you told me it'd be a clean job, no casualties. There were more eyes on that town than there needed to be.
Yeah, well...
Watch it!
According to my eyes, Trevor's your problem, Dave, as much as he is mine.
He's not a problem at all. We're monitoring him. Has he said anything about Brad?
Fuck yeah, he has. Plenty.
Hey!
I keep changing the subject. You know, he thinks you might actually commute Brad's sentence when this is all over.
That's good. Fine work. We'll send another letter. It's about time anyway.
Oh, so that's you who's been sending those fucking letters to Trevor, huh?
Yeah. He thinks they're from Brad, who he thinks is locked up in high security and not, well, not 6 feet under in a grave marked Michael Townley. The trainees write them. It's a good exercise.
Yeah, the fuck. How'd that get started? Damn! How'd that get started?
A few years ago, a letter came to the federal prison system addressed to Brad. It wasn't signed, but it gave a P.O. box in Sandy Shores. I played the part of Brad, and we started a correspondence.
Yeah, thanks for telling me, Davey.
I was doing you a favor. Didn't think you'd want to know he was in the same state.
Yeah, so now what? I just sit back and hope he doesn't figure it out?
It's worked so far.
He's a time bomb, Dave, and you fucking know it.
This'll do.
All right. Find out who we're looking for.
Yeah, we need a description of the target.
Yeah, I'll take care of it. Loosen him up.
No, no, please. I tell
what?
You what
loosen
you want.
Him up.
No, no, please.
Break him, Mr. Phillips. How many volts do you think they got running through these things?
You're going to kill me! I will die! And you will kill me! Whoa! Oh! Please!
Down there who might be an Azerbaijani?
Fuck do I know? You might be an Azerbaijani for all I know. What's one look like?
They look Eastern.
Half this town looks Eastern, Davey. You got the fall of the Shah and the collapse of communism to thank for that.
Anyone stand out?
No, they all kind of blend in. Make a call, Dave.
We're gonna need some more info on this guy. They're having a party down there.
That ain't gonna cut it, my friend.
Shit. Let me think. I remember.
Sorry, too late. Trevor, show our contestant what he's wanted.
I remember. Okay. I remember.
Nothing to complain about here, pal. This is totally legit.
What if you get it wrong? Say this! Torturer! My mouth! I will drown! No! I got blood in my mouth! I will drown! Paul!
It's all in your head, Ferdinand! Don't worry!
Let up! You might drown!
Help me pick this up!
I'm alive!
The government knows what's best for you.
Then the government should kill me.
So what have you got for us? We need Trev to shake up your memory again?
No, please.
I think you're making this up.
No, I'm not.
Huh?
No.
Yeah?
I'm telling the truth.
Bushy beard? Got any beardy types at this party? Huh? Because that's all Mr. K's given us.
No.
You know, I'm thinking maybe we ought to just take two bullets and put them in our informant and just call an airstrike on Chumash Beach.
We're back in. Give me some eyes.
Who am I looking for?
Steve's saying beard. What do you got?
Anything specific, or is some stubble gonna cut?
Okay.
And then we'll work our way down until someone fits the profile.
Now, there's a few beards at this party. Vinewood's full of weak chins. The place is famous for it.
Damn. Beards are in fashion in Chumash. Land of beach hipsters. We need more. We're stuck without details.
Did I just shoot somebody?
We can't move until we get the information.
It's gonna be a long day until you give us some intel on our target.
He smokes like a fucking chimney.
I don't know. Trev, maybe one more time? Just to be sure.
No, please, no. Huh? I told you, he smokes. That's all I know.
One more time.
Where you want it?
Nowhere. Come on. Please.
I hope you're not scared.
That's what happens when you put the body through the ringer. I'm taking a shot of this after him.
The light. Let me go do it.
Mr. K. Okay.
He chain smoked. And he's left-handed.
What's that?
He chain smoked. And he's left-handed.
Okay. Any of these bearded guys at the party smoke cigarettes? Mr. K says he smokes like a pack of two a day.
Redwood cigarettes?
Thank you, Mr. K.
Steve's telling me he chain smokes redwoods.
It ain't the cigarettes that'll kill him. It's the guys who put the warnings on the packets you should worry about.
And he's left-handed.
Oh, now I get it. You're telling me to assassinate a guy because he's got facial hair, a cigarette, and he's left-handed. Ah, I see someone. He fits the profile. Yep, fits it all the way. I got a good feeling. About as good as you can get while clipping a guy who probably don't deserve it. Now I'm taking a shot. Baby, I got someone. Definitely a lefty. Redwood smoking, bearded, maybe, could be, used to be, Azerbaijani.
Good enough for me. Steve, it's done.
Woo! That is a wrap, my friends. Excellent work, the pair of you. Now, I got a racquetball game to get to, so Trevor, if you take care of Mr. K, I think we're all set.
What the fuck do you want me to do with him?
I would say he's outlived his usefulness.
Oh, come on, please.
Shut up!
That's a sport.
Let's go, come on.
Wait a second, Mr.
Fuck, let's just go, okay? I ain't gonna let those G-Man fucking scumbags tell me what to do.
What? You just tortured me.
Don't ask too many fucking questions. Let's go, get up. Come on, up the fucking stairs.
Get you to the airport. Oh, safety first.
Yo, I feel kind of bad that I just almost killed. I pretty much killed him.
Are you gonna hold it together?
I want to go home. I want to see my family.
No. You have no home. You have no family. That shit is over.
I do. They're in the morning wood. I love them very much.
No, that's your old life. That's over now. You're off the grid. You're one of the invisible people.
Just take me home.
I'm taking you to the airport. You're gonna get on a plane. You're flying a long way from this country, and you're gonna spread your message.
I don't have a message.
You're a torture advocate.
Advocate?
The media and the government would have us believe that torture is some necessary thing. We need it to get information, to assert ourselves. Did we get any information out of you?
I would have told you everything.
Exactly. Tortures for the torturer, or the guy giving the orders to the torturer. You torture for the good times. We should all admit that. It's useless as a means of getting information.
I'm pretty lightheaded.
Sometimes you torture for the torturee, but only if they're prepared to pay.
I am very unwell.
It's me with you. Jesus Christ, good grief. I thought we really bonded, but now I'm having my doubts. No one drives me to the airport.
Alright, we're gonna kill you, right?
Run. You're free.
What? My family is here.
Your family is probably the ones who got you fucking in here, alright? And look, trust no one, alright? You're alone now.
Really?
Yeah, really. Now let's go. Fuck off. Come on.
I want to see, I don't even know if you can see him again. He like fell down the stairs, my dude. He probably got away. Let's see, where do I go now? Go over to Michael.
Come on, 357 ammunition, protecting your rights.
Yo, let's visit him. Where can I go to visit him then?
Tragic storm in Liberty City that has the nation caring again.
My UFO crashed, claims Hiker.
Eyewitnesses thought they'd seen the crime of the century. Instead, it turned out they were watching a training exercise at the IAA headquarters building in Los Santos. It seemed like a daring raid in which a suspect was snatched by a man dangling from a helicopter. But no! Officials were quick to counter these rumors.
Globopol has gone on a media blitz in the last 24 hours to promote their tough new crackdown on U.S. drug trafficking in the extra hope that more people will discover who the hell they are. In a recent poll asking U.S. citizens what Globopol does, only 2 out of 10 people correctly identified the International Police Force, with the other responses ranging from antidepressant medication to watching a movie to turn...
Yeah. Okay, let's go ahead and go over to Michael and see what Michael has to do.
Later, Dave.
Probably got something. You know, I haven't been Franklin for a while. Let's see what's popping with Frankel, actually. See if Franklin's in any trouble.
I swear, half my life in track.
Alright, so I'm going over to Michael's, right? All the way over here. Jesus. Damn, that traffic disappeared. Oh, God. Okay, Les will be his second place. I don't even know if I can call him. I just randomly called him.
I don't listen to my messages, but I probably listen to yours. Do with that as you will.
The bitch. You know, I follow nobody. Okay, I'm never doing that ever again. Alright, where am I going? Take me to Michael. Care less, my dude. All right, where you at, Michael? Yeah, I have like half of mine to get the other car. That red car, bro. I like red. It says to meet him in his house. I'm at his house. No, fuck it. You, car, come here. Okay. I could go over to Lester from here. All right, let's see what Lester wants. Why am I here? Who is that man?
What's up, man?
Sit down and face forward. Now, I don't have a lot of time. I know you need money. Did Michael tell you about Life Invader?
Oh, shit. Y'all two did that?
Look forward. We're two strangers having a friendly chat. And don't pretend that you liked Jane Norris.
Oh, man, I don't know, homie. I mean, yeah, the dude outsourced worked the child slave. Then stole and sold everybody's private information. And even ripped his own friends' ideas off and walked around like the Messiah while doing it, but... Man, I don't think the nigga deserved to have his fucking head blowed off on TV.
Oh, well, aren't you just... just a moral majority. You know, that's why the world is the way it is today, when a paid thug gets all namby-pamby when someone asks him to act like a paid thug, and for a good cause.
Man, check this out, homie. I like blowing motherfucking fools' heads off just as much as the next psychotic asshole. But I just don't look at the shit as doing a good deed.
Well, now you can, because it's not fools' heads, it's assholes' heads. And not just heads, you know, trashing cars or planting lies, forging evidence, anything we can do to take the battle back to these turds. You know, we'll fix the market in our favor and we'll right a few wrongs while we're at it.
Shit, okay, cool.
Right, so, you heard of Mollus?
Hell yeah.
Okay, so there's a new Mollus, sort of a super Mollus, and it's called Priapol. It's giving the living rigor mortis. Only Brett Lowry, CEO of Bilkington Research, paid off the FDA, and he doesn't care that his hardness pills are giving desperate middle-aged men the world over heart attacks.
Damn, man, that sucks.
Yeah, it does. Now, Mr. Greedy Lowry is staying at the Von Krastenberg Hotel in Richmond. Of course, he'll be well protected, but if he goes away, then America goes back to using Mollus, and Beta Pharmaceuticals gets a big bump in the price of their stock.
Damn, man, all right, fuck it, I got you.
I thought that you would. Now, consider using a sniper rifle or sticky bombs, you know, whatever. Do it your way, however you want. I'm gonna make the investment. We don't speak about this or anything. Now walk away, and I'll stay here till you're gone.
Oops. Oh, there's my car. Okay. Hmm? I don't know if we're supposed to, like, wait until the time's down. Can I restart? No, I'm just gonna get up high and kill myself. I can't reach him. Okay, there we go. Okay, I'm just gonna snipe him down because I ain't know what to do. Now I know. You know what? What would be easier is if I just get a sticky bomb and like put it on his car. That'd be like the easiest thing. Let me go in stealth mode. No, let me get that. Do I have any stick? Nope, I have no sticky bombs. Looks like I'm sniping him. I am sniping that man. Let me get up really high so I can just snipe him from there. I keep feeling like a fool. I already know what to do. I just can't do it. I'm a fool. I want to duck. It won't let me duck. Okay, we're gonna wait here until he gets a 40. Or until he says, clear out. I'm gonna have cops on me either way, so. So just telling from that, I'm gonna have cops on me. So we can shoot him from his car, or we can shoot him from just as he's coming out. I say we shoot him in the car. No, I say we shoot him from when he gets out, because rip it out. Assassinate the target.